Welcome back to today's edition of Valley Homes on TV. And we're going to be talking today about the Milpitas market update. Just a reminder, I've got Stacy Bird with Fidelity National Title and Asta Durham with Advantis Capital in Morgan Hill. And just looking at what's going on here locally in Milpitas, I can let you know that in November, we did have some activity, although it's a little bit lower than expected. But overall, 42 new listings came up in Milpitas in November, and that put the current inventory at 153. Of those numbers, only 9 were closed sales, and the average days on market is about 54. We had an average selling price of $774,000, which we just talked earlier, Stacy, about the alarming statistic that actually the price has increased.
In the area of Milpitas, it has,
right,
compared to last year.
On your statistics, mm-hmm. And you actually gave me those numbers, and I thought those were pretty interesting. Based on 2006 pricing, the median price was $711,000. And then based on 2007 numbers, we jumped to 734,000. Is there a reason why you see that change in the market?
Well, I think Milpitas is a community where people really, they love it. There's great schools here, great school scores. It's a community where people, it's a close-knit community. People like being around an area like that where they're part of the community and people can get involved and...
That's good to hear. We want to keep Milpitas
a great
community.
Yeah, it's a safe city to live. There's a great police department.
Right.
So there's a lot of amenities that make Milpitas an attractive place to live.
I couldn't agree with you more. Now, Asta, in your taping of your shows in San Jose, you must go through a housing market update.
We do some information on that.
Right, and what are you seeing generally in the marketplace?
Well, you know, there's always those areas that are desirable. I mean, I'm sure like Milpitas, the, you know, west side areas that are always going to be desirable and that they're always going to have appreciating values, mm-hmm. and they're always going to be kind of doing well. There's some other areas that have kind of shifted a little bit. And I think with the change in the economy, you know, the gas prices, some folks that had moved farther out to have more affordable housing, unfortunately, have made some changes and made some choices to move closer to their business.
You know, that's true. In fact, I got a call from a gentleman this morning. Mm-hmm. He wants to locate from Modesto back out here.
Mm-hmm.
So I think there is a trend that's starting to take place.
Absolutely. And that's, I think, where you're seeing where there's a lot more inventory in, let's say, Central Valley or out kind of the Hollister, Los Banos area. It's folks making a decision to relocate closer to their work.
Right, that makes a lot of sense. And you know, we are creating a lot of jobs here, particularly right here in Milpitas.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll be giving that in my project update about what's going on right here locally in Milpitas. Asta, I'm going to turn the floor over to you.
Okay.
Let's talk about interest rates. What can buyers expect? And obviously that influences price value and what a seller can get for their home.
Absolutely. Now, interest rates are phenomenal right now. And I don't think that word is getting out enough. I think, as you know, we pointed out earlier in the conversation, really getting good information out to viewers and to people to let them know this is really a great time to buy. Interest rates are historic low. We actually 2 days ago saw them reach lows that we hadn't seen since June of 2005.
Now, is that reflective in the drop in when the Feds drop the discount rate? We talk about national rates.
Mm-hmm.
How does that affect the mortgage rate?
Well, people always, when they hear the Feds have dropped rates, they go, oh, my mortgage rate, what's it now? What's going on? And that, we need to explain a little bit how that works. Now, most home equity lines are based on the prime rate, and that's what you've seen. The Feds have been dropping those rates and also the discount rate. Now, that's something completely separate. That's where that's the rate that where lenders can borrow money from banks.
Okay.
And so that doesn't actually affect the first mortgages like you would think it does. In fact, a lot of times that creates a negative impact in the bond markets. When there's a rate change, you'll see some volatility and sometimes a negative impact initially, and then it'll kind of balance out a little bit.
Well, I've always been asked the question by potential borrowers or buyers that come into the marketplace, what's the difference between, say, a jumbo loan, mm-hmm. a conforming loan, and there's different interest rates applied to each one? How does that work?
Absolutely. So a conforming loan here in California is $417,000 and below.
So in other words, they can borrow only that amount.
Correct.
That's not necessarily the purchase price of the
property. Correct. So if they, let's say, had a $600,000 property, and they were willing to come in with, you know, a down payment of so much, their loan amount might only be $417,000. But that's the maximum amount you can actually get a loan for to be in a conforming loan program.
And I understand also a conforming loan, is that guaranteed or insured? There's a federal insurance, and that's, they're the ones that regulate that conforming loan limit.
Exactly. And when we're running loans that are in a conforming loan amount, we have a whole Freddie Mac, Fannie Mae guideline, you know, underwriting and whatnot, kind of falls into a whole different category.
Okay. All right. Is there any advice you'd give to buyers right now on what they're, what they should do and how they should approach buying a property?
This is the year of the professional, as we've been calling it. And really, they need to work with professionals like, you know, both of yourselves and in your various industries. They need to find a professional real estate agent, you know, lender and title company to really work with to make sure they're getting exactly what they need. Those folks are meeting their goals and whatnot. Because there is more inventory out here than it has been in past years, it's a great time for getting exactly what they want. They have a lot of choice out there. So they want the 4-bedroom, 2-bath in this certain neighborhood of Milpitas, in the school district, whatnot. Now is the time to really go after that.
Well, Asta, do you recommend a buyer contacting a lender or as yourself first in order before they shop to understand where they fit into the loan program and what to look for? And
absolutely. A pre-qualification is really important. That really helps the real estate agents as well, because now someone has come in with kind of a an amount that they can afford, that is truly affordable for them. It's not a stretch. It's very comfortable. And that really gives the real estate agent an idea of where to be looking.
Very good. Very good. Well, we're going to be wrapping up this segment and talking about some of the other topics that we have, which was the title industry. That will be next. So we're going to take a break right now, and if you have any questions or concerns and you want to talk about them or have them bring them up on the air, you can contact me at debbie@vhotv.com, and I'll be happy to email you. And so stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Clara County Association of Realtors is a trade association for real estate. You have to be through the local association, like Santa Clara County Association of Realtors, be a member of the National Association. We have a code of ethics that all of our members follows. The real estate process is definitely more complicated than people think. There's upwards of 100, 150 pages of documents we have to understand and be able to explain to our clients and help them understand.
At the Santa Clara County Association of Realtors, I was able to obtain what I needed to become a realtor and bring that value to my clients.
You know, I've known Michelle for a number of years, and I know that she's been in the business for a number of years. As a real estate professional, she has access to a lot of information that's extremely valuable to us, and that's something that we can do for ourselves.
I think that our real estate market is considerably different from most areas of the country. People use the internet a lot more to look for homes, to find real estate agents, to gather information on buying and selling a home.
Doug did a number of things that we found very helpful in the process. He was there to negotiate with the sellers. After we negotiated the deal, he was there to help us find reputable service providers, ultimately there to help us work through the inspections and close the deal.
Doug prepared us for everything that we had to sign. He made sure we knew what we were signing and what it meant.
For more information, contact the Santa Clara County Association of Realtors,